If you were worried that suddenly Cheryl looks like an old man, no, that hasn't happened. I'm Ted. Cheryl is actually in France today touring with her musical theater. So she isn't able to be here. So I'm going to be sort of emceeing for us today. Jerry's going to perform for you most of his ARCT program. He's going to actually be doing his ARCT exam this weekend, and so this is sort of a dress rehearsal for him, for the real thing, except when you have a real audience, that's much better than just, you know, playing for a camera. So thank you for being here today. Jerry is going to start out with three preludes by George Gershwin. These works are a wonderful fusion of classical and jazz styles. Gershwin had one foot in each realm and was equally gifted. And so the three preludes by George Gershwin. Thank you. Sense, it's not particularly melodic. It's all about rhythmic drive and rhythmic energy. And so it's really quite an exciting piece to listen to, but not for the melody so much. Although there are melodies here and there, mostly it's about rhythmic excitement.
Thank you.
that one. It's one of Chopin's better known works, and it's just one beautiful melody after another. The ballade in A flat major.
Thank you.
Chopin wasn't very good at organizing things. So he just wrote endless beautiful melodies. And he often wrote in ternary form, sort of ABA, where you have a beginning, a middle which contrasts, and then you repeat with some changes. Beethoven had a completely different style. He wrote melodies which were extremely interesting, but often very short, and he turned them into gigantic works. And this next sonata is a very good example of that. Before Beethoven wrote this sonata, he was already very, very well known, very highly regarded composer. After he wrote the sonata, he was just flat out famous, and his publisher was just flat out rich. everyone wanted to play around with the Pathétique sonata. The interesting thing about it is that the entire sonata is rebased on one thematic idea. And it's the basis not only of the first movement, but also the second movement and the third movement in somewhat disguised form. Jerry, can you just play the main theme from the first movement? Okay. And then in the second movement, that's transformed into... basic harmonic structure is there, but it's just simplified enormously. And then in the last movement, it becomes... So really, out of about a six-note theme, we end up with an entire sonata. If you would hold your applause until the end of the third movement, because you really need to hear all three movements together to get the effect that Beethoven's doing. It's kind of a wild emotional journey. Because there's everything from rage to delight to joy to anguish. Everything is here. It's the whole meal deal.
Thank you.
throughout the 19th century, there was a great interest in writing studies, pieces that forced students to learn to do very difficult things. And Chopin was one of very few composers who was also a great teacher. And he had a lot of private students, but most of his private students were aspiring concert pianists. And so he wrote a set of studies, but unlike many of the composers, like Czerny, for instance, who wrote 800 studies, three of which are very good pieces, and the rest of which are very difficult, which was the idea for them to be difficult. Chopin wrote only 24 etudes, Opus 10 and Opus 25, with 12 etudes in each one, but these are all written for concert pianists. These are not for, you know, a typical grade 6 student. You'll break all your fingers. Jerry's going to play one of the weirdest of them. It is quite weird. In fact, it's nicknamed the wrong note etude, because it consists of a series of dozens of wrong notes in the opening section, then the most beautiful, serene, harp-like middle section, and then back to a series of wrong notes. But these are very carefully chosen wrong notes. And it's quite wickedly difficult to play, but it's really quite charming to listen to, because as one of my colleagues said, it starts with a nightmare, and then there's a beautiful dream, and then the nightmare comes back. Okay? Thank you. have a wonderful day.
You too.
Thank you guys for coming.
That was fabulous.
That was a real gift for us. Thank you so much.